And that's a story maybe that isn't appreciated. I'd probably do better if instead of in front of a lot of people talk about exactly that issue and find out what has been said to your parents. You see, what can happen is they may not understand, but they may be brought to understand that what it is you're trying to do by behaving in an Islamic way is to improve yourself, that in fact you're aiming for the same things they want by different means. They would like to achieve the same things that Islam achieves by this practice. They might want to do it some other way, or maybe they don't know how they could do it. And if they can finally appreciate but your goal is the same as theirs, you're trying to do it differently, they might encourage that. My wife's parents were very upset with her for a long time. Thought she'd lost her mind. But little by little they came to understand, why does she do this? She mentioned to her father one day that she thought she might like to get a job during the summer. And he said, how are you going to get a job unless you show your employer some shape? And as fast as he said it, he realized, what am I saying? And that was the day it made a difference to him. He said, listen to me, I'm telling my daughter, show your shape so you can get a job. He didn't talk about that anymore. He suddenly realized what he'd said and realized what it was she was trying to do was maybe a better thing than he was against. But he didn't clarify that till he heard himself say it. And that had reached down to a period of time now where not too long ago somebody, or my wife's mother, had asked her one afternoon when she was staying at their home. She said, the sun is almost set. Don't you have a prayer you're supposed to do before the sun sets? My wife said, oh, there's still time. She said, well, you don't want to miss it, do you? Now, that's a big change over a period of a few years, because it sunk in that it's not a matter if she's done something strange, it's a matter if she's trying to do what I think is a good thing in the results. She may be doing it differently so that people can come to an appreciation of that. And maybe if you could tell the story better as to why it is the Muslim women do as they do, they might realize that, well, that is a solution to a problem that I know exists, and maybe they can appreciate what you're trying to do. So, like, because I don't know the details there, I can only give you parallels to that. When I was here in January in Abu Dhabi, a Lebanese man at the hospital there, a Christian, said he wanted to be a Muslim, but he wanted some advice. He says, what shall I tell my parents? And I said, tell them you're trying to be a better Christian. That when you do the things Muslims do, you already, I give them three examples, are following the example of Jesus, which they have neglected. So maybe they'll see it in that light. That you didn't turn against this, you tried to do more of the good thing. That you are trying to be a better follower of Jesus. It may seem strange to say that therefore makes you a Muslim, but maybe that's the way it works. Okay? I guess you've got to outline goals for people instead of details. Yeah, actually, that's the other thing, that you'd be surprised that it doesn't always cause trouble. It does sometimes. It depends on what you wear. They'll tell you in London, if you want to wear a chador, like the Iranian kind of thing, yes, you're asking for trouble to go out on the street. People recognize that. If you dress Islamically, that is, you follow guidelines but not styles, most people won't even recognize you. My wife got on a bus one time, and a man looked at her, and he said, good afternoon, sister. Thought she was a nun. She was 9 months pregnant. I don't know what it was. I don't know what he was thinking of, but he just thought, well, that's very nice. Because it doesn't cause the difficulties every time that people think it does. It causes the difficulty if you assault people. There are man I know in San Francisco that virtually every week somebody comes to Islam because of his invitation, that is through him, and yet the Stavlik brothers, they wanted to know, why is it that we don't get that response? So he said, well, come with me, watch what I do. And he approaches people, he talks about Islam. They'd approach people, people find an excuse, they run away. Why? Because they look like something, they look like they're ready to... They rode off the screen Lawrence of Arabia or something, you see? It frightens people. Because they come with a full gear, and all that people see is a strangeness, and they back away. So you can follow Islamic guidelines without necessarily imitating a precise style. You can still satisfy all the requirements. Then you've set people at ease. In other words, you could cover yourself Islamically and really not... In fact, it's a funny thing. I wish I had a picture of it. In Toronto, there's an ad at all the bus stops, or many of the bus stops, about a fashion magazine. And it has a picture of a woman in the latest fashion, and it's hijab. That's the latest style. I mean, it's the whole thing, this whole piece like this. It's a thing that will come and go, no doubt, in a period of a few years or something. But right now, that's high fashion. You want to look rich and elegant, you dress like that. You see, so it's hard to imagine now, at least in Toronto, how you would cause some trouble or how you'd make even your family feel bad if you dressed Islamically, because right now that's high fashion. That's what people will be very excited to see the clothes my wife got from here, because that happens to be what people want there. Okay. Is that all the time you have? Yeah. Okay. Yes, thank you again. Alhamdulillah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the night.